Well, Christmas of 96, my older brother and I, we got a VCR along with four VHS tapes. We got The Big Green, Toy Story, Independence Day, and also The Mask. I will be reviewing The Big Green. This VHS tape is special because this was the first movie I ever saw that had any extras on the actual tape. This movie had a music video, which was Stand By Me by Timon, and Pumbaa was there as well. It was really funny, it was really fun, and honestly, I really enjoyed it. Disney's The Big Green was released in 1995, and it stars Olivia Diabo as Anna Montgomery, Steve Guttenberg as Tom Palmer, Patrick Renna as Larry, and you also have Bug Hall as Little Newt Shaw. Honestly, I really enjoyed the acting in this movie. I thought it was very believable. I really enjoyed what Anna Montgomery and Tom Palmer brought to the table. The story is very simple. The Big Green is your classic underdog story. The kids in Elma, Texas, and the overall town, they're depressed. People are out of work. The kids have no future, and overall, the entire town has no future. And overall, though, this story was really, really well done, in my opinion. They bring hope to the entire town. It's a really good lesson that it doesn't matter if you're small or what gender you are or any of that, because if you work hard, you can achieve great things. And overall, I think it's a great message for kids. The protagonist would be Anna Montgomery, who is a teacher from England on a foreign exchange program. She will be in Elma, Texas for one semester. Tom Palmer, who wants to be with her and gets roped into being a co-coach. And also the kids of the class, who have no future in the beginning of the movie, but later on, Anna Montgomery, spoiler alert, she actually motivates the students with soccer, which is an interesting tool, but it worked very well. The antagonist would be Jay Huffer, who's the coach for the Austin Knights. He used to live in Elma, Texas, but he moved away. I believe he becomes a worker for the IRS. He comes back eventually, I guess, and he becomes an overall jerk. He makes fun of people from Elma. He humiliates the Big Green in the first game. And overall, Jay Huffer believes in winning at all cost, and he wants to humiliate his opponents. Overall, though, I think he was a great villain because he provides a great contrast between him and Anna Montgomery slash Tom Palmer. The protagonists, they believe in giving people a fair chance regardless of gender, height, or any of that. Whereas Jay Huffer, he does everything he can to win, and that's all that matters. I liked that the team, at first, they developed an enthusiasm about the actual game. They got okay at it, but as I alluded to, they lost to the Austin Knights. And then they found out that Juan was actually really good at soccer. And once they found out, they recruited him, and then things slowly changed for the better. And I loved their overall slow climb through the ranks. It felt believable because you had the team struggle at first, but then they get better and better and better. And by the time the final game comes, they were all great. And speaking of the final game, it was so exciting to watch. I loved watching it. This time, things were a bit different between the Big Green and the Knights. In the first game, they got decimated, without question. But this time, the Big Green were holding their own. This time, the Knights were struggling a lot more, and I love that because, yeah, I wanted the Big Green to win, but this time, their experience was showing, their training was showing, because they were doing much better. But unfortunately, they were still losing. They were losing 2-0, and then Juan comes back. And what an entrance it was. Juan sprints to the field, the music playing, the beginning is excited, especially Kate. You have the fans there erupting. Their savior comes back. Their only hope. Juan comes back, and the Big Green is now a well-oiled machine. And thanks to Juan, they work together, and they tie up the game. It was very exciting, and now we have a shootout. Before I talk about actual shootout, I want to talk about Larry, who was played by Patrick Renna. Now, Larry is the goalie, but he has this problem. When he gets scared, the people on the other team become monsters. In this movie, we saw Terminators, we saw pirates, mummies, and of course, knights. But overall, this wackiness, I guess, really came to a boil in the final game. Anna Montgomery gave him wise advice that was to become part of the nightmare. And because of this, Larry overcame his nightmare, so to speak, and he blocked 2 goals. I won't give away too many spoilers. This movie is almost 20 years old. I feel old, but I still try to not give spoilers. At least, not that many, because there are people that have not watched this movie before, and frankly, I don't want to ruin it for them. But I will say that Juan's attempt at scoring the goal was freaking awesome. Juan was great, without question, the MVP. However, I will say that Little New Shaw, the best choice to go last. He was the heart and soul of the team. He was what the team was all about. It was about giving people chances no matter how small they are, no matter their gender, no matter anything. It was about fairness. It was about being an underdog. Frankly, New Shaw was the smallest one in the team. The best choice. I will say, watch for both teams when they score a goal or lack thereof, and you will see a contrast in the way they handle things. The Big Green, they were a family. Yeah, they wanted to win, but you know what? They were tight. You could tell. And frankly, the Knights, they didn't have that about them. All they cared about was winning, and frankly, it showed. But once again, the keyword here is contrast. They were handled very well, and honestly, a great job by Disney. The ending I thought was perfect. You had a great celebration. The right team won. A great message. I love the music, especially the song by Nikki Harris, I Believe in You, which was played in the beginning of the movie and also at the end. I love the acting. Great characters. They're very believable. You had Kate's dad, who was a drunk and overall a lousy father, but later on he turns things around. I won't tell you how, but overall it was very well done. You had kids that were lost, but they needed guidance. They needed someone to believe in them, and overall it was all done very well. This movie was a surprise for me, but an overall pleasant surprise. Comment down below, tell me your thoughts on this movie, and I'd love to hear from you. Thank you for watching, folks. Good night.